Sarah Blake, Neutron Star. At the museum, I stand on a scale that tells me how much I'd weigh on a neutron star. Trillions of pounds. I could walk the 20 miles around it in a day or two, except not at that weight. Wherever I ended up on the star, that'd be it for me. And also, I'd be burned up faster than you can tut your tongue. And also, I'd be imploding from the pressure. I guess I'd be a mess of ash pulled quickly to the surface, and then that'd keep burning. Neutron stars are the densest, but that's only because the ones with more mass turned into black holes. I'd rather not say those don't exist, that those anti-exist. I'd rather say those are still dense stars, just more dense, more dense. Someone feels like trillions of pounds in a suit that's counteracting feeling like trillions of pounds and rotating rapidly through the universe. And while they're gone, one of the animals that's returned safely dies from a complication no one and everyone foresaw. But it's okay, because the person standing on the neutron star expected that. And it's okay because they don't believe in living on Earth anymore. They don't believe in it at all.
When I was a kid, I used to think that whenever I would throw a peach pit or an apple or pear core into some random patch of dirt, for nature, entropy, or time to have its ways with it, a tree of the corresponding foot would one day grow there. Once I grew up a bit, I realized that the likelihood of that happening was rather small, since a combination of very specific parameters was needed for a tree to actually grow there. Besides, even if it did, I probably wouldn't be there to notice it, or it would die, or someone would take it down. What's more, the image of a fully grown tree I had in my mind was so far removed from what fruit trees actually look like, or how they work, that even in the unlikely event of a tree growing where I had disposed of said core, pit, stone, seed, I wouldn't even recognize its result. Then, I grew up a bit more and realized that every single germinating essence of nature that I had grown into a tree. And now, I am surrounded by majestic, beautiful trees that blossom around me in all the chromatic colors of an inner rainbow. Engulfs me, and I swim in a sea of pears and peaches and bright green apples, and the heady elixir of their being is everything I ever needed to live my life. Embraced by my supple, gorgeous trees that had taken root instantly, whenever I had thrown a seed into some random dirt patch, for nature, entropy, and time had had their way. This is not a metaphor.